Taking a look at today's interest rate markets, I want to focus on the 10-year note today. We're seeing a nice rally in the 10-year, continuation of this uptrend really for the last several weeks. We're seeing the 10-year pushing up to some high levels, actually, when you look at it from over the last several months. Basically a six-week high here, currently right around the 129.26 level. Now, we did see it over the 130 handle briefly today. We saw 130.01 as the high print in the future today, but selling off a little bit this afternoon, but nonetheless still maintaining this upward trajectory. And when you look at the price action, I think I got a point at a couple of the driving factors today. At least from a short-term perspective, maintaining this upward trend, the continuing narrative and theme coming out of China, where you're seeing this coronavirus continuing to pick up traction, concerns now that it has definitely flowed to other countries. I think the first case in the U.S. was announced here in the last 24 hours. And with that, you know, there's still some concern as to the real economic ramification. But in the interim, we did see some selling pressure in China overnight. And I think that's part of the reason why we saw money continuing to flow into the bond market, particularly the back end of the curve when you look at the 10s and the 30s. Also, we had an ECB announcement this morning, and Christine Lagarde, now the new president of the ECB, indicating that they didn't make a shift in rate policy per se, but she definitely was very dovish in her tone, indicating that they still see sluggish growth coming out of Europe. They remain in a very accommodative type of mindset right now, and that will persist as long as they feel that they have to continue to push forward with some of these initiatives, liquidity provisions, to try to stimulate economic growth. And couple that, again, with the low inflation environment we continue to see across the globe, that's another reason why I think we're continuing to see a pretty firm bid here under the futures markets when you look at the interest rate environment. Also, some of the trends in place, I think you got to point out a couple of interesting points today. The two-year note, actually, outside of that big volatile move that it had overnight when we saw the attack on the Iraqi installations, two-year note really is at a four-month low when you look back over the course of the last several months. We're looking at a two-year actually trading below, from a yield standpoint, the yield went below 1.50 briefly today, closed back above there around the 1.52 level. But definitely when you look at it from a technical standpoint, you're seeing that two-year yield pushing down now to levels that it really hasn't attained outside of that one volatile event on January 8th. You have to go back to October. So you're seeing that, again, yields maintaining the lower end of the range for the last several months. And when you look at the price action on the 10-year, you're looking at a yield right around the 1.75 level. And mortgage rates as well, I want to end there today. We saw now with the dynamics within the market structure, mortgage rates going to three-month lows. The 30-year went down to an average of 3.60 or 3.6%. That's the lowest average in the last 3 months. And if you look at the five-year ARMs, you're looking at about 3.28 or 3.28%. Again, a three-month low for both those types of durations when you look at the mortgage market. So once again, further strengthen the interest rate market when you look at the bond markets rolling higher, and we're looking at the back end of the curve outpacing the front end of the curve today as for the price action.